So cycling with the M, we did 114.5 kilometers, and let me just see what the Garmin register weights, and that's 114 kilometers, so not miles, kilometers. So I put them on at exact the same time. Oh no, that's not true, because this is 3 hours 53 minutes and this is 3:49, so perhaps I think that the Garmin stands on like the stop function. When you stop the bike, when you just want to drink or eat something, then it stops, and perhaps the Polar doesn't. But that doesn't explain the difference in kilometers. So 500 meters off, that's like one, let me see, 0.4%? 0.4% difference in distance. But let me just finish this ride and just show you all the stats of this Polar. And now it's going to rain, so good time to go inside. So inside, let's just finish the ride on the Garmin Edge. So saving the ride. This is now already paused, so let's just hold it for 3 seconds and then it's also ended. Let's see what it tells us. Just the cycling stats. Oh yeah, I've reached my activity goal for today, and that's kind of a nice look, nice feature with all the sparkling balls on the screen. And you can see that here in this circular shape on the end, and you can see the this week sporting time. And here it tells that we are at 364% of the activity goal. And this is the cycling trip data. So the 3 hours 53 minutes and 55 seconds today, 28th of March. And this is this run that I did. Well, it was more like hiking. So the stats on 14.5 kilometers, and trying to zoom in for you correctly. So if you like the video, by the way, just hit the thumbs up button. That would really help the channel. So 114.5 from A to B. Heart rate average 125. Max 170, and that was like that we did a little sprint up a hill, small hill, but nevertheless it was a hill. For me it felt like it was a hard climb for me, because it was the end of the day, end of the race, and there was quite some heavy wind, and we were just with the two of us, of course, in these times. So that was kind of hard for me. 170 is for me quite high. My average heart rate is low. I'm really an endurance sport, so the longer the better. And yeah, that's just how it is for me. This is the zone information, so the average of the time that you spent in all of the zones. So in zone 5, only 25 seconds, and I think that was that sprint up the hill. So a very small hill, of course, yeah. Then 20 minutes almost in the zone 4. I think that was just wind on the head and just yeah, pushing the pedals. And mostly zone 3, a little bit of 2, or no, not a little, also quite a lot. And in 1, so energy use, so 2219 kilocalories, carbs, fat burning. So up a hill, now you can see it, it was like 62 meters, so woo. And that was not only, that was not one hill, of course you had a small humps and bumps, but yeah, here in Netherlands that's quite a lot for a normal flat ride. And what's interesting, of course, you saw that, I think that we went 89 meters up and 62 meters, or 89 meters down and 62 meters up. So that's a little bit strange. Polar, that's a little bit strange. So these are the lab times, not very interesting. This is lab data, so one lab of the 113 and the other of 09. Heart rate time. And so now we are back. So you can just see all the stats when you go up and down. You can just toggle through everything. And this is one screen back. And you see, you saw that arrow, but here isn't an arrow, so you can't zoom in here. But if you go like here, it says the arrow, and then you can push this button here on the right, the nice button with the blue, oh sorry, the blue, the red small jewel there. And there's two buttons on the left, and you can see all the data sensors on the back measuring everything. Does it measure now? Yeah, there we are. Let me zoom in for you so you can see that. And of course, Polar is, I think, the best brand in measuring everything by the wrist. And you can see that it has a little bump here. So it pushes a little in your wrist. And you can see still here the prints. And I have it now off for like 10 minutes. And you still can see the print. So you have to tighten it up. And what I mostly do, just wear it. And when I go sporting, I make it a little bit more secure. So normally this. And when I go sporting, I just, yeah, one or two holes more. So it it's really not letting in any lights on the side. So that's how you can see that it measures accurately. So I was telling here, we go up and then we see all that data. So there we are, just going back, still the Sunday, and then you feel like all the stats, the serene, so the, yeah, more the breathing, meditation app, the fueling, timers, and you can of course change the watch faces, the fitness test, the boring setting, and you can the test and the debug. So that's what we have here on this nice Polar M2. So that's it. Thanks. Bye bye.